Hi everyone, and welcome to the .NET Beginner Series. My name is Claudio Regio, and I'll be taking you through it. So let's go ahead and get started with what is .NET. .NET is a free, open source, cross-platform development platform. I know that's a lot of words, so you can take them one by one. So first of all, free is free. We do not charge anything to be able to use .NET. Open source means that we develop in the open. That means you can see the code that our team is writing to develop .NET, and we actively encourage the external community to submit PRs to our repositories to help change the direction of .NET. Cross-platform means that it works and runs on Linux, macOS, and Windows. And a development platform just means it has programming languages and libraries. So when you put this all together, it's a free development environment where developers can build applications for their customers. What languages and what tools can you kind of use here? So .NET supports C#, F# and more. And as far as tools go, you can use your favorite integrated development environment such as Visual Studio or Visual Studio Code. Now you're a beginner and you may be asking yourself, there's a couple options here, which one do you really recommend? So since F# is the functional programming language and C# is the object-oriented programming language, we recommend you start off with C# and Visual Studio Code. If you keep watching, I'll actually be showing you how to get started with both of those two. So what can you build with .NET? Almost anything. You can build web apps and services, mobile and desktop applications with one single code base, cloud-native applications, IoT, APIs. You can build almost anything. So whether you're a new developer who's just getting started on your journey, or you have experience and you're interested in .NET, we very likely have a home for you here and you can build what you want for your customers. Then you might have heard of .NET and .NET Framework, and aren't these two things the same? How are they different? So let's go ahead and take a look at a side-by-side that'll clear things up for us. So on the right side, we have .NET Framework, which is the first rendition of our product that only ran on Windows. .NET is the modernized version, which runs on Linux, macOS, and Windows. It's also open source, and like I mentioned, it accepts contributions from the community. .NET Framework, on the other hand, the source code is available, but it does not accept contributions. And then modern .NET is where all the innovation actually happens, and we support more application types. .NET Framework has security and reliability bugs on a monthly basis. Modern .NET is also not shipped with any particular operating system, whereas .NET Framework does come out of the box with Windows and is updated by Windows. But the biggest difference I actually want to call out here is that modern .NET is recommended for all new development. So when you're a new person taking on a new project, we highly recommend you go with modern .NET. Now, it can be a little tricky sometimes to understand which one you're downloading, so let me go ahead and give you a little cheat sheet here. So when you see version 4.8.1 or lower, that is .NET Framework. That should really only exclusively be downloaded if the project that you're working on exclusively calls for it. If you want to use modern .NET, you're looking for any version 5 and above. Obviously, we just had our .NET 8 release, so we highly recommend that you install and work with .NET 8. So now that I've kind of given you the lay of the land of what is .NET, here are a few more resources you can take a look at. We have the .NET website, our documentation, where you can actually download, and the Hello World tutorial. Now, if you stay for the next video, I'm going to show you how to install .NET and how you can get started with VS Code and C#. See you in the next one.